Welcome to Roughing It with Ruth, the channel where everything is a bit rough around the edges. In this video, I'll go over how my gear worked out for my 2016 Fish River Canyon hike. I'm really sorry about my voice. I've been putting off narrating this video till the last minute in the hopes that it would get a bit better. But of course, as is the nature of these things, it actually seemed to have gotten worse. Anyway, I'll try to edit out all the hacking and coughing that I do in between narration takes. So, I wasn't quite able to stop myself from making a couple of last minute changes to my gear list, and I'll explain those first. When we arrived at Ice, I realized that there was very little chance that we were going to have any rain on our hike, so I ended up leaving my mountain hardware rain jacket in the car and instead just took one of those disposable plastic emergency ponchos. I was very happy with this decision because we didn't have any rain and the disposable plastic emergency poncho weighed almost nothing. We also spoke to a few other hikers at Ice who had just completed the Fish River Canyon, and we found out that the water level in the river was so low that we'd likely never have to take our boots off, so I decided to leave my Crocs behind. This was really not a good decision because they were also meant to be my camp shoes. And when you leave your camp shoes behind, you end up stepping on shards of skeleton sticking out of the sand when you're stumbling around at night to go to the toilet, Ruth. Don't do that again. The only last minute addition to my pack was this tiny pack of 10 wet wipes. They weren't strictly necessary, but they were quite nice to have. The minimal extra clothing that I took with me worked out quite well. I was able to wash one set and allow it to dry while wearing the other. I must say though that the gloves and the beanie/balaclava were totally unnecessary and I wouldn't take them again. I also never had to use my down jacket, but it did make some nice padding for my pillow and was nice to have. Unfortunately, this bug head net just lived in my pack. I never took it out even once, and I definitely would not take it again. Although I did end up using my headlamp quite a lot, it's an e-gear one. Everybody else on the hike had much nicer headlamps than I did, and in the end when I got back, my awesome friends gave me a much nicer black diamond headlamp, which I will definitely be using from now on. Even though it was only used for minor injuries, my first aid kit did end up getting pulled out quite a lot, and I will definitely take one with me on every single hike that I go on. Something else that got pulled out a lot, like multiple times a day, was my water filtering system. It's not to say that there's nothing wrong with it, it is a bit slow and it takes quite a lot of effort to squeeze the water through the bags. But I really loved this system. The water was amazingly clear and tasted great, and it really gave you peace of mind. The one thing that I did not think of was that the entire system would be slightly wet the entire time, and I should have put it inside of a Ziploc bag. Luckily, one of my fellow hikers could help me out. I really do recommend taking an extra Ziploc bag and definitely also take an extra cup for scooping water out of the river and into the bags, as it's not easy to fill them up otherwise. My toiletries I was pretty happy with, but somebody else had a sponge instead of a face cloth, and that did work but better with the Sea to Summit soap flakes. And I know that I seem to harp on about this a lot, but really, sunscreen is extremely important in the Fish River. The sun is brutal. A pleasant surprise was how well this lunch tin with lid worked as a bowl. Sand really does tend to get into everything on the Fish River, especially if the wind is blowing and you're trying to rehydrate your food. But when you've got a lid that you can clip closed, this just isn't an issue. You can also pour some water into the lunch tin, close the lid, and shake it vigorously as a pre-wash. This works surprisingly well. The MSR reactor stove was its usual awesome self. I think I actually ended up boiling water for two people at most meals, and it's just so fast and easy to use. I don't really have any complaints about the food that I took along, except that the one meal that I cooked with cheese was a little bit difficult to clean up afterwards. And I also committed the cardinal sin of forgetting to bring any tea with me. I did take hot chocolate, but no tea. My Thermarest sleeping pad gave me a great night's sleep every night, and my Blue Kazoo sleeping bag, although massive overkill for the Fish River Canyon, was very comfortable and warm. and I have such mixed feelings about my top tent. I really wanted to love it, but because it doesn't have a sewn-in bathtub floor, the sand was just too much of an issue for me, and I ended up sharing a tent with someone else after the first night. We did use it as shade the one day when we stopped for camp, which was quite nice, but I still don't think that I would take it again on the Fish River Canyon. Thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see more videos like this one.